Paracetamol, a tiny pill with a strong impact, has shaped the landscape of pain relief for decades. From its humble beginnings to becoming a global household name, this pill has come a long journey in the medical field. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. Paracetamol, also known as acetaminophen, is one of the most widely used medications in the world. It is over-the-counter in many countries and it is used to treat various conditions like pain, fever, and inflammation. In 2020, it was the 118th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States with more than 5 million prescriptions. Now let us explore its history. Paracetamol was first synthesized in 1878 by Harmon Northrop Morse, an American chemist. Some claim that it was possibly made in 1852 by Charles Frederick Gerhardt. It was first used clinically by von Mehring in 1890. However, it was not until the mid-20th century that its analgesic and antipyretic properties were discovered. Analgesics are substances that relieve pain. Antipyretics are substances that reduce fever. In early 1950s, researchers at McNeil Laboratories in Fort Washington, Pennsylvania, began to develop paracetamol as a commercial product. They recognized that paracetamol was a safer and more effective pain reliever than aspirin, and they believed that it had the potential to be a major breakthrough in the pharmaceutical industry. The word acetaminophen is a shortened form of N-acetylaminophenol and was coined and first marketed by McNeil Laboratories in 1955. In the same year, McNeil Laboratories launched the first paracetamol product called Tylenol. Tylenol was a huge success and it quickly became the most popular pain reliever in the United States. The word paracetamol is a shortened form of para-acetyl-amino-phenol and was coined by Frederick Stearns and Co. in 1956. Concerns about paracetamol's safety delayed its widespread acceptance until the 1970s. But in the 1980s, paracetamol's sales exceeded those of aspirin in many countries, including the United Kingdom. This was accompanied by the commercial demise of phenacetin, blamed as the cause of analgesic nephropathy and hematological toxicity. Available in the US without a prescription since 1955 to 1960, according to an estimation, paracetamol has become a common household drug. Paracetamol quickly gained popularity as a safe and effective alternative to aspirin, which was the most commonly used pain reliever at that time. Paracetamol's popularity continued to grow in the 1960s and 1970s. It was introduced to new markets around the world and it became available in a variety of new dosage forms, including tablets, capsules, suspensions, syrups, and suppositories. Today, paracetamol is one of the most widely used medications in the world. It is available in over 100 countries and is sold under a variety of brand names, including Tylenol, Panadol, Calpol, etc. In India, it is widely sold as Dolo or Calpol. Paracetamol is a chemical compound with the formula C8H9NO2. It is a derivative of aniline, a heat-sensitive and a weak base, which is a toxic compound. However, the addition of an acetyl group and an hydroxyl group to aniline makes paracetamol much safer and more effective as a pain reliever. The chemical structure of paracetamol is responsible for its analgesic and antipyretic properties. The acetyl group in paracetamol allows it to bind it to an enzyme cyclooxygenase, COX. COX is responsible for the production of prostaglandins. Prostaglandins are chemicals that play a role in pain and inflammation. By binding to COX, paracetamol inhibits the production of prostaglandins, which reduces pain and inflammation. Paracetamol seems to work by blocking the chemical messengers in the brain that tell your body that you have pain. It also reduces a high temperature by affecting the chemical messengers in an area of the brain that regulates body temperature. It works effectively for up to 4 to 5 hours in general. Paracetamol is a relatively safe medication because it is metabolized by the liver into non-toxic compounds. However, it is important to note that taking too much paracetamol can lead to liver damage. It is excreted through urine. Paracetamol is being prescribed to treat a wide range of conditions like pain, fever, inflammation, etc. In general, paracetamol is effective for the relief of mild to moderate pain such as headaches, migraines, muscle pain, back pain, and arthritis pain. Paracetamol is effective for reducing fever caused by colds, flu, and other infections. Paracetamol is effective for reducing inflammation caused by minor injuries, arthritis, and other conditions. It is also used off-label for a variety of other conditions such as dental pain, menstrual cramps, and nerve pain. The recommended dosage of paracetamol varies depending on the age, weight, and medical condition of the patient. It is important to follow the dosage instructions on the label or directed by a healthcare professional. Paracetamol is generally considered to be a safe and effective medication when used responsibly. However, like all medications, it can cause side effects, especially when taken in high doses or for extended periods of time. The most common side effects of paracetamol are mild and include nausea, vomiting, stomach upset, and headache. More serious side effects such as liver damage are rare but can occur, especially in people who exceed the recommended dosage or who have underlying liver conditions. Also, paracetamol can interact with a number of other medications including blood thinners such as warfarin, anticonvulsants such as phenytoin and carbamazepine, antibiotics such as rifampin. It is important to disclose all medications you are taking to your healthcare professional before taking paracetamol to avoid any potential interactions. As on 2023, over-the-counter analgesic paracetamol formulations have been banned in countries such as Syria, Saudi, Bangladesh, Iran, and Kuwait because of analgesic abuse nephropathy. But it is followed in India due to its par excellence as an antipyretic drug. Paracetamol is still available over-the-counter in most countries. This makes it a convenient and accessible medication for many people. However, it is important to remember that over-the-counter medications are still drugs and can cause serious side effects if not used properly. It is important to read and follow the dosage instructions carefully and to talk to a healthcare professional if you have any questions or concerns.